Thank you. Thanks. Here we are in the Murrow Room, and I think that it's very fitting so, because it was 60 years ago that in perhaps his most well-known and well-remembered TV broadcast, Edward R. Murrow said, "We cannot defend freedom abroad by deserting it at home." He said that at a time when it was essential for journalists to step forward, to lance a boil of fear and intimidation that had gripped official Washington for years and the entire country as well. That was 1954. Here we are in 2014. And the events today are part of, I think, a very strongly accelerating effort across this country to lance a boil of fear and intimidation. We don't talk anymore so much about a chilling effect. We talk about a freezing effect. We talk about ice cubes that congeal. We talk quite properly and accurately about an Obama administration that seems determined to gut the meaning of the First Amendment. As the petition that we presented this morning to the Department of Justice spells out, it's really the functionality of the First Amendment that matters. It's a brief petition, and I'd like to read the entire brief text to you. To President Obama and Attorney General Holder, your effort to compel New York Times reporter James Risen to reveal his sources is an assault on freedom of the press. Without confidentiality, journalism would be reduced to official stories, a situation antithetical to the First Amendment. We urge you in the strongest terms to halt all legal action against Mr. Risen and to safeguard the freedom of journalists to maintain the confidentiality of their sources. Well, as Myron mentioned, and it was 14 on Monday, statements released on that day by Pulitzer Prize winners. Since then, there have been six more who have approached us to add their individual statements. All of them are posted at rootsaction.org, where people can also find a way to sign on to the petition, which is ongoing. And let me just briefly emphasize that the names on the petition we dropped off and that are on screen, they're not just names. They're an activist network. We know how to reach them. We do reach them. We have everybody's email addresses. And we're just getting started here. It's all about organizing at this point in terms of mobilizing the kind of social understanding and political pressure that's going to be necessary to turn around what is truly a deteriorating, dreadful situation. The many organizations involved are only in part represented here, and folks that we're going to hear from today are speaking for just one of the, or a few of the many groups that are involved. And I want to emphasize really that we're embarked now on something that might be unprecedented, a collision between an administration that talks good and does bad, and a mobilized citizenry that increasingly understands what's at stake. Today really marks the culmination of one phase of that growing effort and the initiation of the next. So we're going to move ahead now with this news conference, another part of this effort to lance that boil of fear and intimidation that's been doing so much damage to journalism and to democracy in our country. I'd like to now introduce Greg Leslie. He is legal defense director at the Reporters Committee for Freedom of the Press. He's been an attorney with the Reporters Committee since 1994 and served as the legal defense director since 2000. He supervises the committee's amicus brief writing efforts and journalism hotline services and is regularly interviewed by journalists on media law topics. He served a lot of positions. I'll just mention a couple. Member of the American Bar Association's Fair Trial and Free Press Task Force, chair of the DC Bar's Media Law Committee, and many other positions. Before and during law school, he worked as a journalist and research director for a Washington business and political magazine. And here he is, Craig Leslie.